Hey guys, welcome back to this week's tech tip. I'm going to show you how to create a form on a landing page. Let's say, for instance, that you are offering an ebook covering specific information within your industry. That is specifically what we're going to do today. So you will go to Marketing, Lead Capture, Forms. So you'll end up right here. You're going to go over to the top right and click on Create Form. As you can see, there are a bunch of different options here. The pop-up box we have covered in a previous video, so I will have that down in the description below if you want to look that over. But today, for today's video, we are going to go over the embedded form, which is going to be in a landing page. Now, HubSpot has a bunch of different templates available. In fact, they do have an ebook download template right here. But for the sake of today's video, we are going to start with a blank template and walk you through it. So you'll hit that and click Start. So the first thing that you want to do is, if you want to see how a specific ebook is performing, you want to have a naming function throughout all of it. What we do is we usually do TOFU to stand for top of funnel. And then today we're going to be doing a case study for one of our clients. So I will put that here. HubSpot automatically puts the email in because it's required. That is how HubSpot dedupes contacts, is based on their email. So you just want to take a look at what kind of data you want to gather about each prospect. We're going to put first name in and last name. And to make it a bit prettier, we are going to move this here so they're next to each other. Let's see, what other kind of information would you like? Let's see about job title. And let's say that we want their company name as well. All right, so if that's all that you want to go through the fields and see, you want to make it required. And there is your form. Easy as that. So we're going to click Update and Publish. Now, and here's the embed code. So if you have your HubSpot forms on a WordPress site, you would just grab that code and drop it into the page. But today we are going to create a page. So I have cloned the previous case study, but I've taken everything out. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to select a form. You'll click right here, go down to here, choose a form, and we're going to pick the one that we just made. There it is. How beautiful. All right, and then we're gonna put a CTA, download the case study. As you can see, it's starting to come together. We really want to showcase the value and benefit that this case study is offering, and we really, really helped optimize this client's website. So I'm gonna say, start optimizing your website today. And the banner image, we want to put a hero image of the case study. So let me look it up in our files. There it is. Look at that, beautiful. All right, now here we're going to go down and we need to add in some information about why they should specifically download this case study. I've got some copy that has already been created, so I'm going to type it in here. Now, as you can see here, this is a little bit janky, so we're going to go back in here and change this. Let's make it a little bit smaller, maybe 20, see how that goes. All right, there we go. It looks better, but let's make that a little bit bigger. That should be good. And then I'm going to add in the other bullet points. As you can see, it's not exactly uniform throughout, so let's fix that. Perfect. Okay, so now this is looking like a really good landing page. You have your branding. You have a header showcasing the immediate value and benefit to the prospect. You have a CTA here, download the case study. You have the image of the case study showing the 10,000 visitors per month that we generated for them. And then you have the form. And you have all this down here that also shows them the benefit. Next, you'll go to settings and you'll change the internal page name to however you guys decide to name specific landing pages or forms in your HubSpot. Make sure to update the page title and the page URL. You do not want to forget to put the meta description in too. And then you will publish it. There you go. That's how you create a form and add it onto a landing page. Next week, we are going to build off of this and create a thank you page as well as a thank you email. And that'll consist of a workflow that goes into it as well. But that's what we've got for this week. So make sure you start building your landing pages and follow all these steps to get more leads.